So in Cue of the Day, I had sent out a couple of tweets, which was, this was the Leia Halpern show. And she asked a great question to Alex. She says, how can crypto companies pay 10% interest when banks are offering practically nothing? And Alex answered the question, kind of. I mean, he pretty much says that banks can make 17%. They don't give you guys squat, but we give you guys a lot. So I just said, hey, is Celsius a scam? To like have people who think it's a scam watch and go, oh, it's, you know, seems legit. So then people were like, oh, so what, you think it's a scam? Like, did you watch the video? So then I had to clarify it and said, hey, do I think Celsius is a scam? No. And have there been some errors? Yeah, there have been. So this was really the big question. And I want to really clarify some things about why I still have taken my portfolio from 30% in Celsius down to 10%. So let's jump in. All right, everybody, welcome back to Cue of the Day. And this was a good one. This was something that I had talked about in my previous video where I talked about Celsius Network and my plans. And if you don't know what it was, I'll just give you a quick recap. Celsius, they had a switchover. They did a what's called a DNS propagation where they had to upgrade their services on GoDaddy. So when you do that for DNS propagation, sometimes it takes 24 hours, sometimes it takes 72 hours. I've done that on both of my websites. And it took about, you know, 24 to 36, but it is kind of harrowing because everything goes down. And they tell you it's going to go down so you can let your customers or members know. So me personally, when I went to upgrade, they said, hey, it's going to be, it's not going to have access for quite some time. So you need to tell everybody. Sure. So I told everybody 1 week out, 5 days out, 3, 2, 1, the day of, 36 hours afterwards, when it was up. And then, of course, ask any questions. And that's just me being a small business owner. So when I saw what Celsius did, I was a little bit concerned because they are a multi-billion dollar company. So I don't, look, I will just say this, no company is 100% perfect, right? There's nobody that is infallible. But for me, when I looked at this, I'm like, well, it's kind of a big mistake. And it's one of those mistakes that they shouldn't have made. And if nobody told them at GoDaddy that this would happen, it doesn't really matter because the people that are required or actually are there to change everything over, they should know these things. And then also as far as like the security team, because, you know, it's one of those things as far as security and customer information, they should also are aware of what actually happened. And I know people will say, well, it doesn't really matter because it's not the cryptocurrency isn't on the website. It's not on the app. It's on the blockchain. That is all true. However, you don't want some kind of data leak going on, and which is what happened with other companies. So as far as the security team, of course, they were involved and they did the right thing. They didn't open it up very quickly. However, I think they should have known. So it's just one of those things where it's a breach in trust. That's all it is. And when I said on yesterday's video, I was going to decrease my portfolio in Celsius, people were not too happy with me because they're like, well, how can you do that? And you should really believe in that. And this is, you know, just a little glitch. So not a big deal. I'm like, wait, it doesn't matter what I do. It doesn't matter what I do. If I do something like that, then that's just me and what my thoughts are. That does not affect you. So if you want to keep 100% of your cryptocurrency digital assets, that's fine. Go ahead and do that. But for me, I just really thought back and go, you know, 30% is kind of a high number to keep on any one centralized platform because you never know. And then some people say, well, it's DeFi. It's not DeFi. It's centralized finance. That's exact. And even Alex Mashinsky will say it's centralized finance. And yes, there is insurance through Celsius, but it is FDIC insured for your fiat. And when your cryptocurrency is there, then they also have a form of insurance. However, when they lend it out, which is the whole platform, and Alex will tell you this as well, when they lend out that cryptocurrency, there is no insurance. So if something happens and that's it, now they do ask for collateral, and that's great. So like if you want to borrow $100, you got to give $150. Well, essentially, that's really how it is. But we have seen instances where other places have said the same thing. We have collateral, and all of a sudden just didn't really work out. Now, there is one bright spot I will say about this. Not one. Celsius is probably far, far and away the best out there that I've seen. And I know people will say, well, what about X and what about Y and what about Z? I don't know about X, Y, and Z. And the ones that I've looked at are not that great. So when we take a look at the history of what has happened, all you have to do is look back to March, when the whole pandemic started and there was a huge crash for Bitcoin and all the crypto assets out there. And during that time, there was and this is the whole trouble that started with CRED. Once that happened, people were like, we can't pay back the loans because we are overextended here and overextended there, and it became a huge mess. So with Celsius, that didn't happen. They said, well, we have, you know, the collateral. And unfortunately, at that time, the crypto collateral went down so far, they're like, hey, you either have to, you know, pay back the loan, or you have to start collateralizing more so you can keep the loan. And out of all those things that happened, they only had to liquidate either 3 or 4 people. I forgot how much it was, but it was a very low number. And that is kind of like your benchmark as to, you know, how well a company can do. I mean, everybody's awesome when the money's rolling in and there's no problems whatsoever. Okay. Look at Bernie Madoff. It was working pretty great for that whole time. But when the waves start to crash, or when the tide rolls in, you can see, or the tide rolls out, you can see who is left swimming naked. So it's one of those things where it's like, well, Celsius passed that test, and that's one of the bigger tests that I can think of that may or could happen now or in the future. So it's a pretty bright spot. However, going back to my thing, which is 30% of my entire portfolio on Celsius, some people say that was a little bit crazy, a little bit too much. Some people say that wasn't enough, but it doesn't matter what other people say. It's what you think and what you do with your money. So for me, I felt like it was a time for a little bit of a cool off period, and I reduced from 30% down to 10%. Now, as time goes on and there's no problems and we see more things, then I will probably add back in. I don't see the problem with that. And then will I keep buying the Celsius token? Absolutely. Why wouldn't I? I mean, it's just going to keep going up for quite some time, I believe. Now, it could go down, but I believe in the platform and I believe in what Alex is doing. But, you know, I just think that it was time to just do a cool down and a pull back. And this is where I'm at. So hopefully that answers your question for today. Let's
jump. That's it. So I hope that answers some questions for you about Celsius. Also, just a quick reminder, Dan Teaches Crypto, the free website is up. And again, we try to simplify everything as far as what is crypto, what is crypto good for, some different investment strategies, not that it's investment advice, but just kind of like the basic things that I find important and things that I think you could actually find important as well. So if you're looking for like the basics type of thing, this is probably the best place to go, in my personal opinion. It's danteacherscrypto.com, and there is a link in the description, and that is it for today. So if you like those types of videos, there's gonna be too much gonna pop up on your left and right, let YouTube do its magic. And that is essentially it for today. So thanks for stopping by. Really appreciate it. And then I'll see you on the next one.